This is GTV News. I'm Pasli Mwangi. I'm going to be your anchor for today. And today we have some news on the presidential address that the president did on the 6th of June. The first point the president talked about was the cessation of movement into and out of the Isili area of Nairobi and the specific limitations in force with respect to Mombasa Old Town area that is currently in force shall lapse at 4 a.m. on the 7th of June 2020. The second point the president talked about was schools will be opening on the 1st of September 2020. I personally don't support that because we don't know how many cases of COVID-19 we will have in Kenya by the time September is approaching, and I don't think that is a very good idea. The third point the president talked about was that the lockdown in Nairobi, basically the movement in and out of Nairobi, shall be extended by a further 30 days. But he also mentioned that he will be addressing the nation on the 28th of June. The fourth point the president talked about was he has changed the hours of the curfew. That means the curfew will now start at 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. the following morning. This allows businessmen and women to open their businesses and have a full day of business without anything like rushing to close down and beat the curfew by 7 like it used to be. So today we will be showing the first day of when the curfew has been changed. And now we'll be talking to Jeremy Ogendo, who is in Nakuru at the moment, in town at around 8:30. Let's go to him. I am now in Nakuru town. As you can see, people are rather doing what they normally do because the curfew was extended from 7 to 9. So now people have longer working hours and they can do what they want. Like you can see, it's now dark outside. Everyone is still in town. Everything is going on like it used to before the curfew was from 7. All right, back to the studios. Thank you. That was Jeremy Ogundo. So today, 152 more people tested positive for the COVID-19. That brings the total number of infections in Kenya to 3,457. This is the breakdown of the cases. In Nairobi, 70 people were infected. In Mombasa, those are 41 cases. In Busia, 16. In Kajiado, 4. In Machakos and Migori, 3. In Kisumu, 2. And in Taita Taveta, Narok, Nakuru, and Uasin Gishu, 1 case each. Now, I personally can't explain how this is happening. I think people should be taking these safety precautions very seriously because we can stop the spread of COVID-19. As our CS would say, my fellow Kenyans, if we continue to live normally, this disease will treat us abnormally. In another story, CS Ukur Yatani highlights significant financial assistance that Kenya has received from external partners. 78.3 billion Kenya shillings from IMF, 108 billion from the World Bank, 22.5 billion from the African Development Bank, and 7.5 billion Kenya shillings from the commitment from East African Union in form of grants. And that has been the budget of 2020. This has been GTV. I've been your anchor, Pasli Mwangi. Thank you for watching.
Virus COVID-19 is a respiratory virus spreading across the world. The infection is spread from droplets of coughing and sneezing of an infected person, touching or shaking hands, or being in contact with contaminated surfaces or objects with the virus. The signs and symptoms are fever, coughing, headache, body ache, difficulty in breathing. The disease can be prevented by regularly washing hands with soap and running water. Avoid close contact with people who have flu-like symptoms. Avoid handshake, hugs, and kissing. Also, protect yourself by covering your mouth or nose using a disposable tissue while coughing or sneezing. If you experience these symptoms and you had traveled or been in contact with a person from a country reporting COVID-19, you should isolate yourself for 14 days and seek immediate medical attention or report to the nearest health center. This message has been brought to you by the Government of Kenya and its partners. For accurate information on COVID-19, dial *719# or call 719. Follow us on Twitter at @MOH_Kenya, @spokesperson_GOK, @WHO.